Hello and welcome to the latest edition of Wrestlescene. I'm your host, as always, Billy. Second time recording this, so just making you aware of that. I'm here to give you a rundown of the weekend's action in professional wrestling in Scotland from our featured promotions on swnscotland.com. If you want to find out more about any of these shows, any of the matches announced, anything listed, go to swnscotland.com or check our socials at ScotResNet and find out more. So there's a few events on this weekend that I'm excited to talk about, excited to get into for a little bit. I like to condense this. I just want to get in, tell you what's on, tell you how to get tickets, and then get out again so you can go and buy those tickets again, go see some wrestling this weekend. So let's have a look at what's coming up in Scotland this weekend. We're kicking off with Community Pro Wrestling. They are coming to Maryhill at the Community Central Halls in Maryhill with seven big matches announced for this show. There's Community Pro Wrestling. This is going to be running twice a month, even three times a month at the moment. So there's a good chance that you're going to get to see Community Pro Wrestling show near you. And this one is stellar, absolutely stellar. So this is taking place on Friday, the 22nd of March. So when this goes out, hopefully that'll be tomorrow. More information, doors open 6 p.m. for VIP ticket holders. There'll usually be a bonus match in there. It's 6:30 for general, 7 p.m. bell time for the main part of the show. Tickets are still available, but limited. Eventbrite.co.uk/Ravy-Davy. I think that's where you'll be able to find tickets. But you can go on to swnscotland.com. We'll try and keep you right where to get tickets, or look for Community Pro Wrestling on your social media. They're everywhere. Ravy Davy is everywhere. TikTok, Instagram, Threads, probably, Twitter, it's whatever, Facebook, that's the other one, Mastodon, I'm sure he's there as well. That he'll be able to get you a ticket, be able to find out where to get tickets and keep you in the right direction. But let's look at the card here. So we've got Cassie Lassie versus Irish star Anita Vaughn. A big match for Cassie Lassie. Still in her first year of wrestling, had her debut in her hometown in Stewarton recently. So a big match for her going against Anita Vaughn, who's hotly tipped to be one of the wrestlers to watch in the UK and Ireland for this year. So certainly a big match for Cassie. Cousin Xander takes on Nathan Black. I think Xander, my recollection, is the CPW is hardcore champion at Community Pro Wrestling. So I don't know if there'll be some shenanigans involved with that title during this match. We've got Leighton Buzzard, fresh from Japan, coming up against Jordan Oliver from the US. Again, big match feel. So Community Pro Wrestling, you get to see Leighton Buzzard coming off of a big tour in Japan for BJW and against Jordan Oliver, who you get to see in likes of Game Changer Wrestling. So the fact that these two are going one-on-one in Maryhill, it's a no-brainer. If you're nearby, you should get a ticket for this. Termination Z, Big Ross Houser and Darrow. I was corrected last week when I was guessing Termination Z or Termination Z, and Darrow was able to send me a message somehow and tell me it's Termination Z, like Dragon Ball Z was the exact wording. Taking on the Handsome Man's Club, recently formed. This team have been around for a little bit, Ronan King and Judas Grey, but now they have a name. Easy for me to say. I'm all flustered by the handsomeness. Ronan King and Judas Grey, the Handsome Man's Club. I'm sure Sam Arbor will be nearby. SBX will be nearby. Ashley Vega was completing the quartet of the Handsome Man's Club, taking on Termination Z. Termination Z, recently their undefeated streak was broken. This will be a big test for them to try and get back into momentum, try to get back on the horse, so to speak, with Ronan King and Judas Grey. Going to be more than happy to try and make that streak, now a losing streak, in the Community Pro Wrestling. So a lot at stake there, especially when we've got a tag team tournament coming up for Community Pro Wrestling. I think that's May. So there's a lot on the line. There's a lot of possibilities here. We could see just a team gain some momentum going into the tag team tournament coming up. Triple threat action. We've got Spider-Man himself. I'm all over the place. Like I say, second time I've recorded this, the file broke like 10 minutes in. And then it lost 2 minutes at the end. And I was like, I'll just re-record the whole thing. It'll be good. Triple threat action. We've got Spider-Man slash Steg taking on Thatcher Wright. And Big Finn will be in there as well. Big Finn, another one who got a match in his hometown recently at Stewarton. And he's got a lot of big potential in Community Pro Wrestling. So Thatcher Wright, former CPW Heavyweight Champion, Steg as well. He'll be looking for some momentum, I'm sure, for the Govan team going into the tag team tournament. So there's a lot on the line, a lot can be gained from this particular match. In the CPW Women's Championship match, Ellie Armstrong will defend against Debbie Keitel. Debbie Keitel, of course, is a big star in the UK and Ireland, a former champion in Scotland as well, way back when. So she knows what she's doing, and she's got a lot of experience as for it. I mean, a former tag team partner is the current NXT Women's Champion in Lyra Valkyria. So she knows what it's like to hold gold as well. She knows what it takes to be surrounded by champions at the same time. So this will be a big match for Ellie Armstrong, who's the inaugural CPW Women's Champion. So this is one of the matches I'm looking forward to finding out more of when the match takes place, and hopefully we'll get to see some footage sometime soon. And in the CPW Heavyweight Championship match, Ravy Davey defends against Wild Boar. Wild Boar, of course, former NXT UK, one of the most respected wrestlers in the UK, Europe, as well. And a guy that brings a wealth of experience. He's also down and dirty, low center of gravity. So it'll be interesting to see where Ravy Davey goes with that, because he likes to throw a match into a bit of a brawl, a bit of a shenanigan fueled contest. And Wellbore is not really one for that. He's wanting to make matches go as quickly as possible. So I'm ready to see how that dynamic pairs off. So yeah, seven big matches announced for Community Pro Wrestling when they come to Maryhill at the Community Central Hall. So if you haven't got a ticket yet, they are very limited as far as I remember. As of recording, 6 p.m. for VIP, 6:30 p.m. General, bell time 7. Get your tickets at eventbrite.co.uk. On to Saturday, Bleeding Gums Wrestling have their Lust for Death tournament taking place at the Beveridge Park Hotel in Kirkcaldy. Doors open 6 p.m. bell time 6:30 p.m. Tickets again are very limited, but if you go to bleedinggumswrestling.co.uk, you'll be able to find out how to get tickets for the show. This one I've done a big preview with over at the Heat Sheet for their Extra Hot segment. So we talked to Andrew from Bleeding Gums Wrestling. We did a lot of chat about this card, this preview, and what to expect from the show, and just the catching up on the story of Bleeding Gums Wrestling since our first chat with them. That was prior to the first show, the Ultraviolence Referendum. So this is the second Bleeding Gums Wrestling show. And talk about a stacked card. I've talked about that already for Community Pro, because it is, whenever we're looking at Bleeding Gums, and it's just as stacked, just as wild. So let's go through what's been arranged for us, I suppose. That's the best way to put it. So in the only non-deathmatch match, that sounds right, British top team Leonardo Darwin, Brett Semtex, and Lou Nixon take on Johnny Storm, Taylor Bryden, and Eugene Mackey. Bryden and Mackey, of course, have a lot of history in Kirkcaldy. Johnny Storm's wrestled around the globe as well, so there's a lot of experience involved. The British top team are coming to, as a team, as a unit, wrestling in Scotland for the first time, so this will be a very interesting contest. Like I said, the only non-deathmatch match on this card, so something a little bit different for the audience to get to see some more of the local scene as well, like Bryden and Mackey, and a little bit more of likes of Lou Nixon, who is a big name, big deal in the UK. When we're talking about the Lust for Death tournament, right, okay, so there's 5 first round matches. There'll be a semi-final and a final, 2 semi-finals and a final on the show. So we don't know what the stipulations are for the semi-finals or the final. We do know what the stipulations are for the first round. So we'll go through them. I'm going to say death match a lot. That's guaranteed. So Lust for Death tournament round 1 in a Saw death match. The triple threat between Jack Bennett, Michael Caden, and Clint Margera, which we went through the stipulations with Andrew. So like I said, I'll point you towards the Heat Sheet. I will link it in the description below as well, the episode, and you can check out the full interview, because it was a really fun chat. I said deathmatch wrestling is not my thing, so it's great to be able to speak to Andrew, and he can educate me a bit more on the particular genre of deathmatch wrestling. And Lust for Death tournament round 1 again, Attack the Block deathmatch, a triple threat. We've got Jack Harrop, Tombe, and Tim Strange. In an Up in Smoke death match, we've got Luke King Sharp against Big F and Joe. Neil Diamond Cutter returns to take on Danny Darko in a Cabin in the Tubes death match. You can probably guess how that's going to go. The list for Death Tournament round one, the final one I've got on my list here. If they build it, they will bleed. Death match. Bolton Thorn against Franco Fate. So a lot going on. Like I say, there'll be two semi-final matches and a final on that card as well. It's going to be a lot of blood, glass, and everything that you can think of for a death match will probably be on that show as well. So check out Clean Gums Wrestling, Lust for Death Tournament, Saturday, March 23rd at the Beverage Park Hotel in Kirkcaldy. And the final show to speak about is a double header. So it'll be two shows. It's Iron Girders Pro Wrestling, IGPW 15. You know what? I'm just going to keep rolling with it. I've got two shows coming up. On Saturday, they have a match, a show at Iron Girders Gym in Glasgow. And on Sunday, they've got a show at St. John's Church in Stevenson. So we'll break down both of them in this particular section of the show. So a lot of the matches, there's been a couple of matches announced officially by Iron Girders. There's been matches that have got match graphics being put up and Iron Girders have shared. So we're going to try and just see what we've got and just put it all together. So the matches announced officially by Iron Girders Wrestling for the first show, which will take place at Iron Girders Gym in Glasgow. Doors open 6:30 p.m, bell time 7 p.m. Tickets are still available at eventbrite.com. Go check out Iron Girders Gym on there and you'll find out where to get tickets or check them out on social media. Iron Girders Gym is usually their tag, so go find out a bit more to get your ticket. So a traditional British rounds match has been announced between Levi, former IGPW champion, against Brannigan. As a breakdown for that, a 6 3-minute rounds contested over two falls, two submissions, or a knockout for a win. So traditional British rules. And the other match we know that's been confirmed is the IGPW Championship Open Challenge. Eddie Castle defends against a mystery opponent. Now, just before we re-recorded this, Elijah Bulwark, the commissioner of IGPW, put out an announcement that this wasn't officially cleared by him. And the fact that after it was announced, his phone was ringing, but one challenger caught his attention, and that's going to be Eddie Castle's opponent. But we won't find out until the night, so keep an eye out for that. Elsewhere, it's been announced for night one. So we'll go through what, like I say, I've seen graphics for or promos for, and like we'll break it down from there. Mikey Devine takes on Adam King, so it's Casino Brutal versus KOA in singles action. But Luke Kaino versus Dylan Thorne for the first time. The Dangerous Brothers, Kez Evans and BT Gunn will be in action. Angel Hayes will defend the ACME Comic-Con Interpromotional Championship, easy for me to say. In an IGPW King of the Fling match, we've got Robbie Cardwell defending against Chris Kingston, Stone Malone, and Gabriel Saul. As well, like I said, the open challenge will be answered. Elijah Bulwark will let us know then as well. So that's night one. That's what we know. I think that's what I've gathered so far from intel on this particular match. For night two, it's Sunday, March 24th, St. John's Church in Stevenson. Doors open at 4 p.m, bell time 4:30. Tickets still available. We know two matches are announced for that, which is Tommy Lockhart versus Logan Smith, former ICW Tag Team Champion. Ellie Armstrong takes on Jay Steins as well in a Scotland versus England in a match style. Elsewhere, we have Angel Hayes, if she successfully defends on night one, will defend the ACME Interpromotional Championship. And if Robbie Cardwell defends on night one, he will defend the IGPW King of the Fling Championship on night two as well. So it's two defenses for those two champions. A big weekend for both of them. So yeah, a lot happening for IGPW, their second anniversary show, weekender. Hell of a lot involved. So that's going to be interesting to keep a hold of, keep an eye out for, to find out more, see what else has been announced. And that's it. Hopefully this has gone through okay. You can hear me and see me, all that kind of jazz. But this has been an episode of Wrestlescene. I have been your host, Billy. If you want to find out more, go to swnscotland.com. We'll try to keep you abreast and updated. Everything to do with Scottish professional wrestling, inside and out. So hopefully, we'll keep you up to date. That's the plan. That's always the hope when we're doing SWN. But if you want to find out more, go there. Find the companies on social media. And in the meantime, go get a ticket. Go enjoy some wrestling. Have a good time.